Most computational problems are not solvable, and using ideas from diagonalization, we are able to formulate a specific function that is not decidable. But that is a very artificial construction. It's not a function that anybody would naturally want to compute, I think. So a natural question to ask is, are there problems that are not solvable, which we may actually be interested in solving? So far, we've not seen any such problem. It could be the case that most problems are not solvable, but it just so happens that all the problems we might be interested in are solvable, and therefore this is not a big concern somehow. But this is not true. So there are natural problems that we might be interested in solving that are impossible to solve. And one such example is the decision problem halt. The halting problem is probably the most famous uncomputable function. It's defined as follows. It takes as an input a bit string alpha, which encodes a Turing machine, and a bit string x, which encodes an input to a Turing machine. And we then ask whether the machine m alpha halts on this input x. If yes, we should return 1, and if it doesn't halt, then we should return 0. This problem is not computable, and to show that it is not computable, we now can use our new technique, Cook reduction. So remember that we had a function that we already know to be not computable. It was this function here, f of alpha is equal to 0 if m alpha run on alpha returns 1, and f of alpha is equal to 1 otherwise. So if m alpha run on alpha either does not terminate or it returns a value other than 1. So we know this function is not computable. We've seen this using diagonalization. And now we use our technique with a Cook reduction, and we reduce this function f to the decision problem halt. In other words, we will argue that if we have a machine that has access to an oracle for the decision problem halt, then we could also solve this problem f. And that leads to a contradiction, because we know f cannot be solved. And this is basically a programming exercise. So we want to write an algorithm or a program that solves this problem f and can call as sort of a sub-procedure an algorithm that solves halt. So here's how that algorithm would work. So we compute f of alpha using an oracle for halt. The first step of the algorithm checks whether halt of alpha and alpha is true or not. So we determine what the value of halt of alpha and alpha is. So we want to know whether the machine m alpha halts on input alpha. If this is not the case, then we return 1. Because we know that m alpha of alpha does not terminate, and therefore we know that f of alpha should be equal to 1. So this is the correct answer in this case. On the other hand, if the answer is yes, m alpha does halt on input alpha, then we can just run that machine. We can simulate this machine m alpha on this input alpha. So we just do that. We simulate machine m alpha on input alpha, and this terminates. We know this now, and we get some result. Let the result be r. Now we just check what r is. If r is equal to 1, then we return 0, because f of alpha in that case should be 0, and otherwise we return 1. So this is the entire algorithm. It shows that we can compute this function f of alpha if we could decide the halting problem. And therefore we conclude that the halting problem is not computable. But it would be useful if we could solve the halting problem. This is because, essentially, this would enable us to have some automated error checking in a compiler. Right? You write a program and you want to check whether your program contains errors. And certainly one error would be if your program somehow could end up in an infinite loop that it can no longer escape from. For most programs, we probably don't want something like this. So it would be useful if the compiler could automatically check whether your program has this property or not, and then alert you and warn you if your program, in fact, would be able to enter an infinite loop. Of course, in this setting, we might also be interested in a slightly different problem. I mean, here the halting problem takes a machine and a particular input x, and it asks whether the machine halts on that particular input. But maybe we also want to know whether the machine halts on all inputs, universally. So this is a slightly different problem. Let's call it halt always. And I will explain to you in a separate video why halt always is also not decidable.